A 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, I love succulents and you do too. They're so beautiful, fun and new. The gift that keeps on giving on and on. So watch my videos, we'll all have fun.
Okay, so I got this cute, so cute little llama. Llama face at Home Depot. Look how cute this thing is, and it has the succulents, which I love. And I know that I don't have this particular plant right here. I think I had it once before, but it died on me. And then I think I have this one. I'm not sure, but it could be a different species. So it's a cute planter, don't get me wrong. It's awesome. It's very cute. However, realistically, I would not want to put succulents in this planter because I know the fact that it's so small that I'm going to have to keep repotting it into a bigger planter once it gets overgrown. So I'm thinking of a different purpose for this llama. What I'm thinking is cutting it right in the middle and just making mosaic out of it, incorporating it into a mosaic frame, and then but keeping this half of this like that much, and then just putting maybe even fake succulents in it or real succulents, but like maybe a different type, something that would, this is like very, very soft leaves, so something that's maybe a little bit more robust and resilient to anything, like maybe a Haworthia or some kind of a cacti, because llamas, aren't they from like the Mediterranean? I don't know, but this looks more Mediterranean, like Bohemian. So I can make two in one. So I cut this in half and I have two different things, planters. But then it's cute, then I'll just decorate all around it. So that's my plan. I don't know if I'm going to end up doing it or if I have time. So it's probably going to be a little bit later. But for now, because these plants are growing too much out of this planter and it's getting really, really, I don't know. It's kind of dry right now. I just have to rescue it right now at this point. So I will show you how I do that. Okay guys, so for now this is the container that it's going to go into because it's one size bigger than this one, I think. If not, I'm just gonna have to repot it when it starts getting bigger again. I don't mind doing that, to be honest, because you know sometimes I just like would replant it in ground. Here to catch everything. So maybe not that. First, I'm going to try to loosen it up by not poking anything at it if it comes out. And the faster you get it out of the original planter, the better it would be, because then it's not overgrown and there's not like a lot of roots that's trying to get out. And I just bought this, I think I bought this like
month ago, maybe, at Home Depot. I just thought that the llama planter was so cute. Boom, 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 boom. Ugh, yeah, it's still good, see? Looks like it came from a plug. They just plugged that in there. Doesn't even look like, I mean, they just packed it in there that it's not even giving it a chance to, like, there's six plants in here. It didn't even get a chance to grow big. So they must have just done this. There's no use throwing away the soil that it came in originally. Just put them back in there. Ooh, you know what? This planter is way too small. So I have to get it. I have to get a bigger one just so they have enough room to grow. It's a little bigger, but it's still not big enough, I think. Okay, so let's try this one. Look at it. Oh yeah, so much room to grow in there. So I'm just going to go ahead and cut one of these nets so that I can put it in the bottom. Something about the soil is making me itchy. And I can reuse. This plant. Ooh. Oh. Oh yeah, definitely this is gonna be. Look, they put this in the bottom, but really if the water pools, it's gonna pool right here in this area right here. So why put the water there? I don't know. Sometimes people don't think anymore for some reason. And this soil right here I infused some worm casting. Of course, if this is your first time here in this channel, you're gonna know, my subs know that I always infuse everything with worm casting. These are so cute. These plants are so cute. I think this is a blue chalk. If I'm not mistaken, it's a blue chalk. Finger. I can't remember what this is. Now you have a lot of room. A lot of room to grow. It's very windy again, which is really not a good thing because it's so hot. Today is the hottest day this week. And it makes me nervous every time it's this hot and then it's windy. It's just one of those signs that scares us here in Napa, because we know that
That's the perfect formula for. I'm not gonna say it. You guys probably know what it is. It's just bad. What do you call that? Bad management of forestry. Okay, so now that I have this here, since it is back into its own soil, if it's your first time here, I just want to clarify, because sometimes I think that everybody's watching all of my videos, but really I'm sadly mistaken, because some people do that, but not everybody does. So I kind of have to explain, and I'm sorry if you've been here before, you already know this, but for the ones that have not seen all of my videos, which I feel like I recommend that you should, when you first repot your plant from one planter to a bigger planter, you always kind of have to acclimate it. However, if it's a cutting, or yeah, if it's a cutting, it doesn't have the roots yet, you have to wait at least a week so that the healed part of the plant starts to grow roots in its new home. But if it's a new home, but you just replanted it and all the roots are still intact, it's like you never did anything. It's like the soil that's around it is still there. You're packing it into the same soil, just adding a little bit more. I would totally water it. Yes, it does have to acclimate to its new home after you replant it, regardless of whether it has roots or not. However, you still have to put, even if you water this, because it has roots, and it's okay because it's so dry. Look at this, it's so dry. But if it's not dry, if it's really wet and you replanted it, which a lot of people say you shouldn't do, but I do anyway, and I haven't had any problems. Once you replant them, it is very crucial that to put it under shady area, but bright light, okay? Shady bright means it's like under a patio, but it's bright around it, that the sun is still on it, on the patio or surrounding, or under a tree that doesn't have a lot of leaves falling on it, for at least 5 days. Okay, but if it doesn't have any roots, I would leave it there for at least 10 days. But this particular one, it's been so dry, so that's why I'm dousing it with water. I need more water. Where's my water jug? And just soak, I would just soak this and then put it under shady area. I have this plastic jug full of water because I don't have a faucet out here in the garage. And that's it. And then I'll just put this under the shade for at least five days or a week. I'll say a week because I hardly pay attention to everything like this. So a week. Oh, and then this planter right here, I'm going to cut this planter in half, okay? I'm going to cut it in half all the way down its body like this, and I'm going to install it so I have two. It's so cute though. Look at this face. Look at that face. It's still going to be cute. So I'm gonna cut it right down the middle here. Right down the middle. Right down the middle there. Let's see if I can mark it with pencil now. Yes, I can. So I'm gonna cut this
smack down the middle. What does it say? Altman plants, llama. It's a llama. Ah, they stuck that in there. They did not want that to fly away. Living treasures. Let's see. Okay. So right smack down the middle. So I have this much to work with. It's not a lot because once I embed that into the wood, into the frame of my mosaic. Ooh, and then I'm just gonna follow these colors. Ooh, it's gonna be so cute. It's gonna be so cute. So just cut that right down the middle. Yeah. So that's the, this is gonna be the future of this thing. I mean, I wanna make it so that it's special, you know, and not just something that sits on a table or something, but that's a cute thing. Look. All right, so that's it. This is going to go under the shade. I'm probably going to put some rocks around it. If I have any rocks in here, do I? No. It's going to be outside. Okay, guys, that's it for now. And we're hoping that this will propagate a lot, lots. And put it on in an arrangement or whatever, you know. They could have just sold me this planter, but whatever. Bye, guys. See ya.